Welcome to Himani Coaching Center. Today we are going to discuss an important topic of class 10th ICSE, which is about shares and dividends. In our last video we had discussed about RD and we discussed about various modes of saving. So what happens in share market is that if a company requires lot of cash, okay, if a company requires lot of cash, what are the options with the company? One, the company or the owners of the company can put in their savings, okay, in the business, and then they run the company. Or they can go to bank, take loan from the bank and then run the company. Or they can, you know, have private investors, like many of the, you know, e-startups in our country right now are funded by the investors from abroad. So these are the various options available. But beyond that, if the capital requirement is so huge that this cannot be met by any of these, then what happens? The company launches a IPO. What does that mean? That means company launches an initial public offering and they launch shares of the company. So what happens? They go to the market and then they offer to the public that, hey, this is our business and we want you to participate in our business by buying the shares of our company. So what happens? There would be lakhs and lakhs of, you know, small investors who will put in maybe thousands of rupees or, you know, some tens of thousands of rupees. But for the company, they get a huge investment. Okay. Now, when the company launches an initial public offering and offers share to the public, at that point of time, company decides the price for the share. Okay. And company says, okay, the price per share, let us say hypothetically, it is 100 rupees. Now, that value is called face value or nominal value of the share, and the people who get the share at that price, they are called the primary shareholders. Okay. Now, when the company gives shares in the market and people are paying for that, what happens? Company every year will come out with the performance of the company and they will start sharing the profit of the company with the public who has invested in their business. Now, this sharing of the profit for each shareholder is called dividend on the share. Okay. So for every share a person holds, he can get dividend from the company. Now understand, this is not a binding on the company to give dividend every year. If the company is making loss, they would, you know, not give any dividend. But for a company to do good and be in the good books of market, they will generally give dividends if the company are doing, performing well. Okay. Now, what happens, the company, when, as I told you, if someone buys the share from the company directly during IPO, they are called primary shareholder. Now, what happens after that is, since the company's performance may become very good, what will happen? The value of the share will start rising. Okay. Now, it may so happen that a 100 rupee share will be available at 150 rupees in the market, because IPOs are not announced every year. They happen once in blue moon. Okay. Now, if someone wants to buy now the share of the company, what option does he have? He will have to go to the existing primary shareholder and buy from him. And if the share value has risen, so this guy will pay 150 rupees for a share whose face value is 100 rupees. Now, this 150 rupees is called market value of the share. Okay. And 100 rupees is called face value of the share. Now, this market value of the share can be higher than the face value, can be equal to the face value, and can be lower than the face value. Okay. Many a companies who are defunct, like, you know, a Kingfisher airline share, today it would not be, you know, no one would buy it even for 1 rupee, because everyone knows that this company is not into business. Now, if a company's share is available at a price lower than the face value, that is called share is available at a discount. If the share is available at par. That means if the market value of the share is equal to the face value of the share, then we say that the share is available at par. And the example which I took initially, if the market value of the share is higher than the face value, then we say that the share is available at a premium. Okay. Now in all this, please remember that dividend is always paid on face value or nominal value of the share. Okay. You will have to keep this in mind in the questions. Whenever we talk about dividend, the dividend is always calculated on the face value of the share. Okay. Now, if you know that, and this market, when we say shares which are available in the market, this market is called secondary market, because now the person who want to buy a share is going to the market and buying from primary shareholders. Okay. Now, what happens? Because shares give very good dividend, and a share market can actually, you know, make, can give you a very high returns. So it is considered a good option for investing your money. But there is a downside also. If the share market is not doing good, your investment can be wiped off also. But let us understand about the share market and take questions from the book and the questions which have come in the board, and then we will get deeper into the theory of shares and dividends. So when we talk about shares and dividends, as I told you, when the IPO is launched and company will, you know, come out with some value, it can be rupee 10 or rupee 100 or rupee 50, that is what company will decide. That value of the share is called face value or nominal value, and this value does not change with time. The face value or nominal value remains same. Now, dividend or profit or annual income, whether we talk, you know, any one of this term means same. That means for a investor who has invested in a company share and the company offers a dividend annually, now that is also known as dividend, that is also known as his profit, or that is also known as his annual income on his investment. Now comes market value. Okay. Now market value, depending on various factors, as I told you, can be higher than the face value, then the share is available at a premium. Okay. So a question may say 100 rupee share is available at 20% premium. What does that mean? That means the face value of the share is 100 rupees. It is available at 20% premium. So 20% of 100 is 20. That means if I want to buy that share right now, I will have to pay 120 rupees for one share. Okay. So that is what is meant by this statement. Then MV can be equal to FV, which is the share is available at par, and MV can be less than FV. That means the share is available at a discount again. So a 100 rupee share is available at 15% discount. So what does that mean? That a share having face value of 100 rupee is available in the market for 85 rupees. Okay, that is what is meant by these statements. Now, when we talk about market value of a share, so let us say a share is available at a premium and the cost is 120 rupees and I want to buy 100 shares of this company. Okay, so what is my investment? My investment would be market value of one share into number of shares which I want. So 120 into 100. So this is my investment. Okay. So total investment is market value of one share into number of shares. Okay. And the profit percent or return on investment. Okay. Why does someone invest in share market? Why do we invest our money basically? We invest our money because we want to earn something out of that money. Okay, a cash lying in my pocket at my home is not a good idea because it does not earn anything. So if I put it whether in bank or in FD or in share market, it gives us some income. Now the profit percent or return on investment in share market is your dividend divided by investment in 200%. Now when I say dividend, a dividend is always announced or calculated on face value. Your investment generally is on the market value of the share, which depending on these three things can be at premium, par or discount. So when we calculate the return on investment or profit percent or rate of return, we say dividend divided by investment into 100%. Okay, now when we talk about dividend, what happens if, let us say again my example, there are 120 shares and company announces 10 rupees dividend per share. Okay, so that means I have got 120 shares, so my total dividend would be number of shares into dividend per share. So 120 into my number of shares, and that's what is my dividend. Okay, 120 into 10, which is 1200 rupees. So total dividend is dividend per share into number of shares, and from this and this formula we can find number of shares also. Let us say I want to know number of shares, when the question gives only dividend, then number of shares would be total dividend divided by dividend per share. Similarly, if I want to know my number of shares when the investment is given, then number of shares would be total investment divided by market value of one share. Okay, now understand this thing. Okay, what did I say? That dividend is always given on NB, while my percentage return or percentage profit is calculated on MV. So there is a relationship which says percentage dividend on NV equals percentage return or percentage profit on MV. Okay, so these are the basics on which we are going to solve few questions to clarify the topic. So just go through this screen once. Okay, note down the formulas if you want, and then we take questions. So now let us rub this off and take few questions. We will start with few very very easy basic questions just to get a feel of the kind of questions which are asked in boards or in exams. Okay, so let me talk about the simplest of the question, which is how much money will be required to buy 400 rupee 12.50 shares at a premium of rupee 1. Now what is the question saying? How much money will be required to buy how many number of shares? So number of shares are 400. Okay, and it says a rupee 12.5 share, that means face value of one share is rupee 12.50. okay, and it is available at a premium. So what is the premium? Premium per share is rupee 1. So what does that mean? That means market value of one share equals face value plus the premium, so it becomes rupees 1350. Now if MV is rupees 1350 and I want to buy 400 shares, what should be my total investment? So how much money do I need? So my total investment should be price per share MV of one share into number of shares which I want. So 13.50 into 400 should give me the total investment. Okay, so this is the simplest of the question, which you know gives an idea of the nominal value or face value, premium, and then market value. Okay. Now let us take another question, which is a man invests rupee 800 in buying rupee 5 shares, and when they are selling at a premium of rupee 115, he sells all the shares. Find his profit and profit percent. So what happens in share market is people generally buy and sell share. Okay, so they will buy and in the hope that the share price will rise, and when it rise they will sell. So what happens, let us say I buy a share at a price of 150 rupees. Okay, so let us take example for only one share. So I buy a share at 150 rupees, and after some time this share is now market value has become 200 rupees. So I will say, okay, now let me sell this share off. So I sell that share off. So what is my profit per share? 200 rupees. What is my investment? 150 rupees. So what is the profit I earned? I earned 50 rupees on this transaction. So this is how a share market works. But here we are talking about profit. Sometimes there are losses also, and people get into losses also in the share market. Now, coming back to the question, it says a man invests rupee 800 in buying rupee 5 shares. So what is the investment of the person? His total investment is rupee 800. Okay. And what is the value of the share? NV of share is rupee 5. Okay. NV of one share is rupee 5. So how many shares this guy will have? So total number of shares should be equal to total investment over NV of one share. So which is 800 upon 5. Okay. So this guy would have got 160 shares. Okay. So this is the number of shares this guy has. Now the question says, when these shares are selling at a premium of 1 rupee 15 paisa, he sells all the share. Find his profit and profit percent. Okay. Now, when the premium is premium per share is 1 rupee 15 paisa, okay, he sells all the shares. So this is the premium, which is what? Which is his profit on one share, isn't it? He bought it at 5 rupees, now he is selling at 6 rupees 15 paisa. So his profit per share is 1 rupee 15 paisa. So what is his profit? So his profit would be rupee 1.15 into 160. Okay, so which we can calculate as 0, 16, 5 is 80, 16, 1 is 16, 824. So his profit, total profit is 184 rupees. Now they are asking profit percentage. So profit percentage is what? It is profit divided by his initial investment. So original investment into 100. So which would be 184 upon 800, which he invested initially into 100. Okay, so you divide 184 by 8 and you get your answer. Okay, so 4 2s are 4, 4 is 16. So this is his profit percentage, okay, 23%. So this is, you know, another question which is easy and which tells us about the ways of working of a share market. Okay, now let us take another basic question. Find the annual income derived from 125 rupee 120 shares paying 5% dividend. Okay, so they are asking us to find annual income for 125 shares. The price of each share is 120 rupees and it is paying 5% dividend. So when nothing is given, that means they are talking NV. Okay, so NV, one share equals rupees 120, dividend per share equals 5%, and total number of shares is 125. We are asked what is the annual income of this. Okay, now dividend is 5% per share, value of one share is 120. So let us first calculate dividend per share. Okay, will be 5% of 120, which is 5 by 100 into 120. Okay, so which is 6 rupees per share. So dividend per share is rupees 6. How many shares are there? 125. So what should be annual income? So annual income equals dividend per share into number of shares. So that would be 6 into 125. So which is 6 5s are 30, 6 2s are 12, 15. So his annual income is rupees 750. Okay, so it is simple. NV of one share is given, dividend per share is given, percentage. We find dividend per share in terms of rupees and multiply that with the number of shares. That becomes our annual income. Okay, now let us take another question. Okay, now let us take another question. It says a man invests rupees 3072 in a company paying 5% per annum. When its rupee 10 share can be bought for rupees 16 each. Find A, his annual income, B, his percentage income on his investment. Now let us deconstruct the question. So what is it saying? A man invests rupees 3072. That means, what is the total investment here made by the man? So total investment is rupees 3072. Okay, now he is investing this money in a company paying 5% per annum. What does that mean? That the company is paying dividend equals to 5%. Okay, when its rupee 10 share can be bought for rupees 16. Now what are we getting? it is saying that NV or FV of a share, of one share, is rupees 10, okay, while market value of one share is rupees 16, okay. So this is the question, and we are asked to find A, his annual income, okay, and second, the percentage income on investment, okay. Now this question could be percentage profit, return on investment, means same thing. Now this guy is investing 372 rupees when the market value of the share is rupees 16. So how many shares this person will get? So let us find the number of shares this guy will buy. So number of shares bought would be equal to what? Total investment divided by MV of one share. Okay, now total investment is 3072 divided by MV of one share, which is 16 rupees. Okay, now let us solve this. 4 4s are 28, 2 27, 4 6s are 4 8s are. Then again it goes with 4. 4 1s are 4, 4 9s are 36, and 4 2s are. So number of shares bought is 192. So this guy, when he invested 3072 rupees, when the market value of share is 16, he gets 192 shares. Now, but question is, what is his annual income? Now, what is the income? Income is 5% on what? On FV. So, let us find the dividend per share. So, dividend per share is equals to 5% of rupee 10. Why? Because dividend is always given on face value or nominal value. So dividend per share is 5/100 × 10. Okay? So which gives us 1/2 rupee. So this is the dividend per share. Okay? Now, the annual income of this guy would be the total number of share he has multiplied by dividend per share. So what is the dividend per share he will get? He will get 1/2 rupees for one share. So his annual income is going to be, annual income equals number of shares into dividend per share. Okay, so which would be 192 by 1/2. Just solve it, you will get rupees 96. So this person is earning a dividend of 96 rupees on his investment of 3072 rupees. Again, let me make it clear, what is his annual income? His annual income is dividend per share multiplied by number of shares, so which comes to 96 rupees. Now, when we talk about percentage income on investment or his return on investment, for that what will we do? His return is 96 rupees on a investment of 3072. So we will now calculate his percentage income on investment. Okay. So answer second is percentage income on investment. So is equals to his annual income divided by his investment into 100. Okay, so which would be 96 by 3072 into 100. Okay, so this is how we calculate his percentage income on investment. Okay, so let us do it quickly. So this would go with what? 16, 6 are 96, 16 ones are 16, and you get 14, 147, which is 16 nines are 144, and 16 twos are, so you get 6 by 192, 6 ones are, 6 threes are 18, 6 twos are, then you had 4 eights are 25, so it is 25 by 8%. Okay, so it you can divide and it will be 8 3s are 24, and then you get 1. So 3.15% is his return on investment or percentage income on investment. Okay, I hope you are clear on one thing, that dividend is always given on face value of the share. Investment is generally done on market value. In fact, most of the questions which come in boards or in your exam, your market value is already given. So you know your investment is, you know, market value of one share multiplied by, now you know, total number of shares. Okay, so now when we talk about return on investment, it would be dividend income as per the face value divided by your investment as per market value into 100. Okay, so if you understand this, then you will have understood the trick of solving these questions. Now I will take few questions which have come in board exams, and then I think that should make it clear to you. Okay, so it says, the question goes like this. This question has come in the board exam of 2014. So it came in 2014. Question goes like this. Salman invests a sum of money in rupee 50 shares, paying 15% dividend, quoted at 20% premium. Okay, now let us first understand this line. Salman invests a sum of money in rupee 50 share. That means the face value or nominal value of share is given as rupee 50, paying 15% dividend. That means company is paying 15% dividend and it is quoted at 20% premium. That means the share is available at a premium. Okay, if his annual dividend is rupees 600, okay, calculate the number of shares he bought, his total investment, rate of return on his investment. Okay, let me just go through the question once again. Salman invests a sum of money in rupee 50 shares, paying 15% dividend, quoted at 20% premium. If his annual dividend is rupees 600, calculate the number of shares he bought, his total investment, the rate of return on his investment. So let us write what all is known to us. So we know that FV or NV of one share equals rupee 50. Okay, we also know dividend offered is 15%. Okay, so your dividend is 15%, and maybe let us write it as 15% of rupee 50, which if you calculate will come out to rupees 7.5. Okay, 15% of 50. Now it is available at a premium per share is 20%. Okay, so what does that mean? So let us calculate the premium per share in terms of rupees. So which is 20% of rupee 50. So it is available at a premium of 20% on face value. So 20% of 50 is rupees 10. That means the face value of share 50 plus premium of 10 is the market value of one share. Market value of one share equals face value plus premium equals rupees 60. Okay, so that's your market value of one share. Now dividend per share is rupees 7.5. okay, now the question says if Salman's annual dividend is rupees 600. So in the question we have been given annual dividend as rupees 600. Okay, now think, dividend per share is 7 rupees 50 paisa, annual dividend is 600 rupees. Okay, and the very first question is the number of shares he bought. So how do we calculate annual dividend? We say that annual dividend equals number of shares into dividend per share. So let me write it as DPS, which means dividend per share. So number of shares into dividend per share equals annual dividend. Now the question is how many number of shares are there if annual dividend is 600 rupees. Okay, equals, let me name this as n into 7.5. n is number of share, so n equals 600 by 7.5, which is nothing but 600. I remove this point and a zero goes up, so 6000 divided by 75. So 15 fives are, 15 fours are 400, 5 ones are. So Salman has 80 shares of the company. Okay, so part one of the question is solved. Part one is that he has got 80 shares of the company. Now part B of the question is find his total investment. Now what is the MV of one share? 60 rupees. And how many shares this guy bought? 80. So what should be his total investment? It's a simple case of unitary method. You know price of one, you are asked price of many, so we simply multiply. So we'll say his total investment equals MV of one share into number of shares. Okay, so that would be 60 into 80. Okay, so which gives us rupees 4800. So part 2 of the question answered. Now let us go to third part, which is the rate of return on his investment. Now his total investment is 4800. On this he earned a dividend of 600. So his rate of return is what? His income divided by his investment into 100. So let us calculate his rate of return. So rate of return equals his income or dividend divided by total investment in 200. So which is 600 divided by 4800 in 200. Okay. So 6 ones are 6 8s are 4 25. This would be 50. So if I am going to multiply this with 4, so it becomes 2. So 25 by 2, which is 12.5%. So what is his rate of return? It is 12.5%. Now let me tell you another method of calculating rate of return, because when we talk about percentage, whether we talk about one or many, percentage will remain same. So his dividend per share was what? 7.5 rupees. And his market value of one share is what? 60 rupees. So dividend of one share divided by market value of one share in 200 will also give me the same thing. Okay. So if we want, we can do this also. Okay. So just to make the concept clear, so we will find the rate of return by dividend on one share divided by MV of one share into 100. So which is 7.5 divided by 60 into 100. Okay. Again, this will become 7.5 or 750. By 60, and if you divide 75 by 6, you will get 12.5%. Same answer. Okay, because see, what are we doing here? We are saying dividend on one share. In the previous part, we had calculated total dividend as given as 600, which is multiplied by 7.5 multiplied by 80 should give you 600. Now MV of one share is 60. He bought 80 shares, so 60 into 80. So we are just doing the same calculation. So this is how you can calculate rate of return. Okay. Now let me take another question from the board. So it is, yeah. Now in this question, the question will talk about a person who buys the shares and then sells them in the market. Okay. So let us talk about the question first. It says Mr. Prakash invested 52,000 rupees on rupee 100 share at a discount of rupee 20, paying 8% dividend. Now let us understand this line only. Mr. Prakash has invested 52,000. So total investment is 52,000. On rupee 100 share, face value of the share is 100 rupees. It is available at a discount of rupee 20. That means one share of 100 rupees is available at a discount. That means market value of one share is 100 minus 20, which is 80 rupees. And this company is paying 8% dividend. Okay. Now, at the end of 1 year, he sells the shares at a premium of rupee 20. Now, he sells the share at a premium. Now, premium is also calculated on the face value. In the market, wherever we talk of premium, par or discount or dividend, we always take face value of the share. Okay. Find the annual dividend and the profit earned including his dividend. Okay. Now let us try to write what all has been given. This question had come in the board of 2011. Okay. So total investment is rupees 52,000. Okay. Face value of one share is rupee 100. Discount, it is given in rupees, is rupee 20. So we will calculate market value of one share. It would be 100 minus 20, which is rupee 80. That's the market value of one share. Okay. And this company is paying 8% dividend. So let us talk about dividend also. So dividend percentage is given as 8%. So let us calculate dividend per share. So dividend per share is what? 8% of face value, which is 100 rupees. So 8% of 100, which would be rupee 8 only. Okay. So dividend per share is rupees 8. Now the question says, find the annual dividend. So we are supposed to find annual dividend. And second is that when he sells the share at a premium of rupee 20, second part is the profit earned including his dividend. Okay. So we'll come to that. First, let us talk about annual dividend. Now, he invested 52,000 rupees. Market value of one share is 80 rupees. So how many share Mr. Prakash bought? So number of shares he would have bought is his total investment divided by market value of one share. Okay, so which means 52,000 divided by 80. Okay. So 4 2s are 8, 4 13, 52. shares Mr. Prakash bought. Okay, so the number of shares Mr. Prakash has is 650. Now for calculating annual dividend, what should be done? Annual dividend is equals to dividend per share into number of shares. Now dividend per share we calculated is 8 rupees. So 8 into 650. So just do the calculation. 8 5 is 40, 8 6 is 48. So Mr. Prakash's annual dividend is 5200 rupees. 5200 rupees is Mr. Prakash's annual dividend. Okay. Now, let us go to second part of the question. And for that, let us understand what does it say. He says at the end of 1 year, he sells the share at a premium of rupee 20. So what does that mean? That the share which he had are now at a premium of 20. Now premium also is calculated on FV. So that means at this point of year, so let us say at the end of year, what is the market value of share? Market value of share becomes 100 plus 20 rupees premium. So that means 120 rupees. That means one share was worth 120 rupees. How many shares Mr. Prakash has got? 650. So what would he have earned by selling these shares? Now this is called sales proceed. So in the share market, whenever you sell your shares, the income which you get by selling is called sales proceeds. So what will be the sales proceeds? So sales proceeds for Mr. Prakash would be market value of one share, which is 120, into number of shares, which is 650. So he would have got ₹78,000 as sales proceeds. Okay, now the question is find the profit earned including his dividend. So what does that mean? Now at the end of the year, Mr. Prakash got 78,000 as sales proceeds, 5200 as his dividend, and his investment is 52,000. So how do you calculate profit? Whatever he earned, okay, 78,000 plus 5,200 minus his investment, which is 52,000. So that way we will calculate his profit. So let us just rub some of it and then solve the question. So his sales proceed plus dividend would be what? 78,000 plus 5,200, okay, which will give you 83,200. Okay, now what is his profit? Profit is 83,200 minus 52,000. So 0021. So this is his profit, 31,200 rupees. Now, as I was telling you in the beginning, okay, this kind of profit is unimaginable. You can't get this kind of profit in a normal saving instruments of bank. Okay, so in the share market, people invest because they have the opportunity to earn this kind of profit. Okay, a 31,000 rupees profit on an investment of 52,000 rupees in 1 year. You calculate the percentage, it is mind-boggling. But the downside is this 52,000 value, if the share market was down, could have been only 10,000. Okay, so his loss also would have been some 42,000 rupees on a 52,000 if the share market was not doing well. Okay, now coming back to this question, I hope you guys have understood how to calculate these things. Okay, now let me take another question, which is page 13. Yeah, this. Okay, so let me first read the question. It goes like this: a man invests ₹8,800 in buying shares of a company of face value of ₹100 each at a premium of 10%. Okay, so by now you should be clear. The total investment is 8,800, face value of share is 100 rupees, available at a premium of 10%. 10% of 100 is 10 rupees, so market value would be 110 rupees per share. If he earns ₹1,200 at the end of year as dividend, find the number of shares he has in the company and the dividend percent per share. Here they are asking us to find dividend percent, which is, you know, dividend percent on face value. So let us first write what all we know. So from the question, what we know is his total investment is 8,800 rupees. Okay. Now this question was asked in the board of 2001. Okay. In the board of 2001, this question was asked. So total investment equals rupees 8,800. FV of the share. Of one share equals rupee 100. Premium is 10%. Okay, and 10% of 100 is 10 rupees only. So which is, let me calculate, 10% of 100 equals rupee 10. Therefore, market value of one share equals 110 rupees. Okay, 100 plus 10, 110 rupees. Okay, now he says if he earns rupees 1200 at the end of year as dividend, so his annual dividend is rupees 1200. Now the question is, find the number of shares he has. Second, they ask us to find dividend per share. Okay, I am just writing it as DPS, which is dividend per share. Okay, now with a total investment of 8800 rupees and when the market value of share is 110 rupees, can we calculate the number of share he has? Yes, we can. So what do we have to do? The total investment divided by market value of one share will give us number of shares he has. So number of shares equals total investment divided by MV of one share. So total investment of 8800 divided by MV of one share, which is 110, he has got 80 shares. Okay, he has got 80 shares. So part one of the problem solved. So he has got 80 shares. Now they are asking us to find dividend per share. Okay, let me just read the dividend percent per share. Okay, so we have to find percentage dividend per share. So what to do? Now what is the annual dividend he has got? 1200 rupees. So, and how many shares does this guy have? 80 shares. So what is the dividend per share? So annual dividend, which is total dividend, divided by number of share gives me what? Gives me dividend per share. So let me first find dividend per share equals annual dividend divided by number of shares. So which will give me 1200 by 80. Okay, so 8 ones are and 8 fives are. So dividend per share is rupees 15. Okay, we are asked to find percentage dividend per share. Now for one share we are getting a dividend of 15 rupees, and what is the face value of one share? 100 rupees. As we know that dividend is always calculated on face value of the share, so percentage dividend per share would be 15 divided by 100 into 100, which is 15%. Okay, so just for the sake of writing this, so percentage dividend per share equals 15 upon 100 into 100. So your answer is 15%. So part 2 of the problem solved. Okay.